Have you been living in Copenhagen for a long time, or maybe you are a newbie but you have still not started with biking here? I hope my story of finally getting started to bike in Copenhagen will inspire you to do the same. So let's get started with today's video. In this video, I want to openly share about my experience about getting to bike here in Copenhagen. So I've been living in Denmark for more than 4 years now, and just last year in August I started with biking, and it was crazy. I reached a point where it was like too much. See, once you move to Copenhagen, one thing that you will notice is people bike here. The next thing that you will notice is that you have a separate lane to bike. The next thing you will notice that you have a separate traffic signal taking care of, especially for bike lane. And then the last thing you will notice is the fact that bikes are given preference over car. So if you are on the bike, the car has to stop and let you pass before they cross. So with so much freedom, if you're still not biking here in Copenhagen, it's kind of like there is no reason, until unless it's like a fear that you have. Like in my case, I've always had the fear of like driving or being on the road where I'm in charge of driving. Last year I saw on Facebook that there's this guy who was starting an event where you can meet and practice, and when I saw that post, I was like, this is for me. I need to go and I need to practice. That time I didn't have my own bike, so I told this guy that I don't have a bike, and he was like, no, just come, we'll arrange or we can just rent a bike. So I just went. There were quite a few people. I think there were around 15 or maybe 10 people. A few were really new, but few also had the bike. I told him that I have the fear, but I know how to bike. And he was like, relax, let's start very slowly. And I remember he had his girlfriend as well, and she was also very sweet. They were not judging you at all. It was like, you know, with friends in a very safe environment, you were practicing. I started practicing, and then suddenly that fear started to go away. Like, this is good. We met again for the second time, and the second time it was like, we are going to hit the road. And I was like, are we sure? Can I do that? And he's like, no, you'll be fine. Don't worry, you're doing good. I needed to make sure that I'm like safe. So I told one person to be ahead of me and the other person to be behind of me so that I don't crush anybody. And once I was on the road and I was biking, I was like shouting, like, yay, I'm biking here in Copenhagen. So I'm going to share a few things that I do. There are a few rules that you need to know when you are biking here in Copenhagen. You will be good to get started. So first, if you are a newbie, like if you are new to Copenhagen, and if you know how to bike but you are a little afraid to go on road, make sure that you get together with your friends or find a group who is doing such activities like the one we had last year, where you feel comfortable with people and somebody is there to guide you, let you know the rules, and just start not directly on the road but have a place where you can just practice. The sign rule, like, you know, you have to be like this, raise your hand when you are about to stop, the left hand, right hand, you will use it when you are going to the right, when you're taking a right turn. The second thing that I definitely do, now that even I'm confident, I'm always using the helmet. One thing that you also need to make sure that you are not biking, and this is what my husband told me, like, I was biking and I was just looking at my own bike. No, that's the wrong thing. You have to always have the vision ahead of you that what the other person in front of you is also doing, because that person might be stopping. Or once you start to bike, you start to see so many things that can go wrong even on the bike lane. Suddenly if somebody is crossing, or I don't know, people are getting out of their cars and it can block the bike lane. Though people are aware about that, they should not block it, but something suddenly can happen. So always make sure that you are not only focused on your own bike, you are looking ahead. The next thing that I do, I don't listen to anything. So I'm not on like on my phone listening to music or anything, because it makes me like in two minds. So I need to be focused, so I don't do that. The next thing that you have to definitely be aware about, that if there is a bus which has stopped at the bus stop and you are going, make sure you stop, because people are getting out of the bus and you don't hit them. I know there have been such incidents when people on the bike have not stopped and they have hit people coming out of the bus. When you are also coming out of the bus, you have to make sure that there is no bike coming, but the priority is given to the people getting out of the bus. So it's your responsibility that you are stopping when you are on the bike. Copenhagen is the city where it is known for the city of cyclists. Okay, Copenhagen is also the city where nothing will be stolen except for your bike. Yes, there's a joke also that sometimes if your bike is stolen, it's like, oh, welcome to Denmark. That's how you know that you are in Denmark. So you have to make sure that you are aware about that fact. And you can buy a fancy bike, but make sure your locks are in place. I have two locks in my bike, still not stolen. I'm very grateful. I don't want it to be stolen. And so know that whenever you are biking, you just cannot just leave the bike like that. You have to have the proper locks. Summer is the best time to bike, I feel. In Denmark, people are biking all the year. So like even going against the wind, so that is what you will always see. But if you're new, summertime is the best time to do it, and now is the perfect time to do it. Find a group, get started with it. You will be happier than ever, and I feel so happy that I could do it and I could overcome that fear. So yes, that's what I wanted to say. It took me 3 years to get started with biking here in Copenhagen, but now that I do it, I feel so happy. Share your fear about biking in Copenhagen and we can talk about it, but I hope you find a group with whom you can connect and get started with biking in Copenhagen. I didn't make this video while being on the bike, because that's what you do. You do not use your phone when you're on the bike. You can see other people doing it, but please don't do it. What else? Yes, have a lovely Friday, and the sun is going crazy in Copenhagen. So go out, have fun. It's my time to go out, maybe on my bike to a beach. I'll see you next Friday with another fun Friday videos with Critical Comedy. Till then, take care and see you. Bye-bye.